start in terms of playing two of the minnows in this competition.
That's right, JP, but it's going to get more difficult. Already, April has challenged her young to outdo the Brazil goal difference.
Well, Brazil has already won their second game. They trounced Trinidad and Tobago, so you can see them at the top of the table. They are a plus 18, and we all know how important goal differential can be in this tournament.
Well, the USA has to beat Costa Rica by 8-0. That gives them the advantage if they tie with Brazil to still win the group.
So in Group A, the two favorites doing quite well so far, as you would have expected. As for Group B, well, China beat Guatemala 14-0, but we warned you ahead of time about some of those high scores in the beginning. Canada and Mexico, that was a good game, close one.
Sounds like a great game. Canada kept its edge so that they should be one of the teams going through in Group B.
And everyone is expecting, of course, a USA-China final. We're a long way from that as the competition will continue on until July 3rd. We told you there'll be changes in the lineup. We'll see them when we come back.
Keeping up with what's going on in Central Texas schools can be difficult. Twice a week.
Well, this is the same stadium where the USA had a lot of success last year. Over 35,000 watched that game against Brazil. Temperature-wise, 85 degrees. Hot day in Louisville. Cindy Parlow coming off the hat trick. Here is the starting lineup for these two sides.
Well, Jenni Branam starting in goal. That's a 19-year-old Phenom. And along with her, Danielle Slayton is a change in the defense. Danielle's had a great year as a run-up to the Olympics. Nikki Serlenga is a holding. We'll be trying to goal
as Lorrie did last time. And then Susan Bush and Sara Whalen surrounding Cindy Parlow on the flanks, and that's a lot of speed up front, JP.
And Tony, a lot of changes, six from the other night, plus there'll be a position change or two. Samson Ross from Aruba is in the middle. She'll be in charge of this one. And we should be set for action. So no Ham, no Lily, at least not at the start. No Foudy. We'll see how the USA plays it in white. Whalen's pass back. They'll try the long ball. Costa Rica going with a similar lineup to what they used the other night against Brazil, losing 8-0. Ball apparently out on the side. Young Danielle Slayton getting a start today. Going inside, chested down. Parlow comes around, that's blocked. Long shot high over the bar, over the goalkeeper, Hera by Serlenga.
Well, April has started her two oldest players, two veterans, Chastain and Fawcett, in the center of defense, and pretty much letting her young players try to get nine goals and give them the goal difference advantage.
Costa Rica trying up that right side. No room there. Whalen with a knock to Parlow. She lost it. Collected by Murcia. And then given up to Briseño, number seven. On the ball wide, Barantes. That one's going to be cleared by the USA. Favorable roll. Now it's Whalen holding on. Into the middle. Making the run. Straight ahead. MacMillan with a pass that's blocked. Costa Rica getting it back. Serlenga trying to go out wide. The offside flag went up on that far side.
Looked like Cindy Parlow was just caught offside. But we're going to get a chance to see Susan Bush out there on the right flank. And she is has incredible acceleration, is very, very fast. You can see here where Cindy Parlow is recovering is just a bit offside.
Second minute, Costa Rica on the ball. Jessica Murcia, only her 11th cap. Murcia's pass left side. This portion of the match being brought to you by IFS, helping to bring you today's match commercial-free. A lot of inexperience on this Costa Rica side. The reason these two teams haven't played each other before, Costa Rica very new in terms of women's football.
Right, I think Costa Rica's only seriously had a women's program the last 3 or 4 years. But JP, I'm impressed with the fact that they already are keeping their shape and they're looking to pass the ball.
That's Laura Palmer. Playing for the club side, Saprissa. You may recognize some of the club teams because the men's teams are also represented there, like San Jose, Herediano, Saprissa, Alajuelense. Here's the USA. Parlow, nice touchback. Serlenga didn't expect it. Give it up near side. Lorrie Fair pushing it left. Slayton came up. looked like she changed her mind perhaps and saw Parlow at the end as that ball went wide. They love her speed on that side.
Yeah, Danielle is very, very fast. This is a fast lineup for the U.S. Lorrie Fair does well to hold the ball up, and then I think Danny was passing the ball there. Let's give her the benefit of the doubt, JP.
No, I do too. I think she may have changed her mind, though, the last moment. Katia Madriz, third cap for her. That ball went out, still belongs to Costa Rica. This team trying to rebound from a trouncing the other night against Brazil. 8-0. And in tournaments like this, you only really have one day off to think about the next team. You're playing five matches if you get to the final in the space of about 11 days. On that right side, that's knocked away. Shannon MacMillan scored again the other night. Serlenga getting the start, pushing it back. It's a younger USA lineup, a faster lineup. Not as much experience, obviously. Here is Slayton. Flying down the wing, and that ball gets through. They like her speed on that side, and April Heinrichs told me the other day she's a great crosser of the ball as well. She's trying to work on her one-on-one defending.
Well, every soccer coach knows that those left-sided players are very, very valuable. Danielle is one of the better ones that we've seen come forward. So she can cross the ball, and she's got a great physique for the game.
This portion of the match being brought to you by Hyundai. We're in the fifth minute. Scoreless USA and Costa Rica. The other night when the USA won 11-0, Parlow scored in the fourth minute. Then they went several minutes before they had another goal. And then the domination began. Pushed all the way back. Slayton. Back to Jen Branham, who starts instead of Mullenix today. Long ball up the wing. Parlow was pushed out. They're going to call it a throw-in for Costa Rica.
You saw Branham take that ball to her left foot. She's very confident with her kicking game. She's probably the best American goalkeeper. Siri Mullenix is very good, but I'd have to give Jen the edge on kicking game from the goalkeeper position.
Chastain working it up the side of the flags. The speedy Whalen got behind one defender. Whalen's in the box. Tackled away. Great recovery by Costa Rica. They'll give up a corner kick, but Contreras made the play.
I think Sarah's last touch kind of failed her a bit. She wanted to bring that ball inside, challenge that last defender, and overtouched it.
Shannon MacMillan will take the corner. Fawcett is going way up on this set piece. It goes far side, cleared away by Costa Rica. And out of play. USA will have a throw-in. Chastain goes over. Chastain's throw, Susie Bush. Back for Chastain, that goes out. And it belongs to Costa Rica.
JP, one thing we'll see today, because Costa Rica is a soccer nation, these players will have more savvy. They'll understand how to kill the time a bit and hopefully how to stay cohesive in the back.
Briseño from Barantes, the right side, broken up. Slayton, very aggressive on the wing. Taken back by Alvarez. Slayton knocked her down as well. A few fouls being let go by the referee from Aruba today. Early on, anyway. Throw in for the United States in the seventh minute. Here is Chastain. We'll have a special feature on Brandi Chastain coming up at halftime if you keep it here. Costa Rica with the ball. Going wide, right side. Slayton has it covered with her speed. That ball rolled out anyway. USA will have it. Danielle Slayton, only 19 years old. She's from San Jose, California. Whalen. And the pass back to Whalen was blocked. Lorrie Fair was up there. Fair may push up even more in her role today, especially with Foudy not starting. Here's Chastain. And now Branham takes it. Lorrie Fair had a couple of goals the other night. Right side, MacMillan. Lead pass. Being chased, and it's caught easily by Hierro. Cindy Parlow was after it. Marie head up. 20-year-old keeper will clear. Costa Rica will keep possession. Played over by Murcia. Give it away. MacMillan will chase. It's coming back near side. Knocked away from Barantes. Sara Whalen was after. It's knocked away from her.
Good challenge and tackle on the far side by Shannon MacMillan.
Intended for Parlow, who was bumped off the ball. And it goes out for a USA corner. Only 20 years old. Marie Herrera getting a lot of experience today. This portion of the match being brought to you by Bud Light as Shannon MacMillan goes over to take the corner. Here is MacMillan with Fawcett again up front trying to create some havoc. It's cleared away by Costa Rica. They've defended these well in the corners on a couple that we've seen so far. Chastain on the throw-in. Ninth minute, scoreless, USA and Costa Rica. USA in their second Gold Cup match, same with Costa Rica. Struck across. Lorrie Fair heads it up and over. Good opportunity for Lorrie.
I think Lorrie might have got caught in just a bit too close on the near on the back post.
Played wide to the right side, and off the Pearce touch, it goes out. Costa Rica's ball.
Let's take a look here. I think Lorrie has to actually take a step back to head this. And if she could have had her momentum going forward, I think she'd be more powerful and have a better chance of keeping it down.
Tony, why is she...
She's tucked in just a bit too tight there, JP.
Why is she so good, though, in the air at only 5'3"?
You know, some of our greatest soccer players in history, Pelé and others, have been great because they have wonderful timing and they have a wonderful mentality to go up and win head balls. And Lorrie Fair has that.
They say inch for inch, she might be one of the best headers around. Here is Whalen. Holding. Playing it across. Nice fake there by MacMillan, getting inside the box. Setting it over. Whalen has to come back for it. Touch back. Big shot taken. Let it go.
Serlenga.
Well struck by Nikki Serlenga. Her third goal internationally.
She strikes this right on the nail, and she positions herself so that she pulls herself back so she can step forward to hit it, which is good sense as far as how to get power behind the shot. What was also good here, JP, is the patience we had as far as building the team, building that final shot. USA kept patience, looked for the right opportunity, and Serlenga finished it.
Nikki Serlenga out of Santa Clara University. USA have the lead. Goal coming in the 10th. Chastain on the right side. Moving it. Susan Bush. Costa Rica will take it back, and they lose it. USA's throw-in. Chastain on the right side. Knocked away from her. Backed up well by the U.S. Joy Fawcett. Over to Slayton. Parlow with a touchback to Serlenga. Going outside. Chastain. Inches forward, goes long in the box, headed by Parlow, but right at Marie Hedda.
Good attack by the USA. Serlenga's definitely making a statement for herself early in this game.
Here's Whalen, cutting it back across in some traffic. Whalen holds, gives it up. Here's a quick shot. USA will get another. MacMillan. And after a good start, Costa Rica is losing that shape that you were talking about.
Right, here's Sara, touches it off to Shannon. Shannon with the outside of her foot. Look her bend that ball into the far post area. Outside of the foot, bends it in. But both these last two attacks have been started by Serlenga distribution.
And for Shannon MacMillan, now goals in five of her last six games. She came off the bench the other night, but tonight, or today, she gets the starting opportunity. She's been a starter for a good part of this year when April Heinrichs switched to a 4-4-2. But today, it's not that formation, yet she does get the opportunity to play.
And it's very important for her to do well in this attacking midfield position. So she started off quite nicely.
USA up by two in the 13th minute. Cut back by Chastain to Slate. Fair touching it back. Serlenga, her goal started it. Pushed all the way across. Christie Pearce. That's broken up. Pearce had a solid game on Friday. Intended for MacMillan. That's blocked. Costa Rica trying to advance at the halfway line. Foul is called on Christie Pearce, who you converted from a striker. What did you see in her where you thought she could come back and play at the back?
She's very competitive. She's got tremendous athletic ability, 29-inch vertical, one of the fastest players, if not the fastest on the team, and she's comfortable with the soccer ball. So that's it in a nutshell.
Here's the long ball by Costa Rica, and it's caught easily by Jen Branham. Branham's long clearance, headed away by Contreras. The U.S. will get it back. McMillan, who has the second goal. Bush on the outside. Another part of that Carolina Tar Heel dynasty. A good supplier to the U.S. national team over the last several years. Serlenga on the turn. Pushing forward. A few touches there, giving it up to Parlow, who ran into some trouble. Cleared away, but there's MacMillan. Going to the outside for Bush. Taking on a player or two. And that one is deflected out. Quarter kick. USA.
Again, good looks by Serlenga. She just missed that pass to Cindy Parlow, but just the fact that she saw it and delivered the ball was showing good vision.
15th minute, Shannon MacMillan ready for the corner. Right to the middle. That one goes well wide of goal. Here is Whalen. And it's going to be knocked out of play. Join us for another MLS edition of Soccer Saturday. Coming up 10 Eastern, 7 Pacific, Kobe Jones and the LA Galaxy taking on the Dallas Bird. Every Saturday, a Soccer Saturday, MLS style on ESPN. Slayton on the outside, headed up and out by Susan Bush. Only 19 years old, but they call her a part of the USA's future. Youngest one in the residency camp.
We brought her in when she was 17 to try to make the World Cup team. And I'll tell you what, she's got something special. She's a hard worker. I think she's going to make it.
Clear to the right side by Costa Rica, but that goes out of play. USA will have another throw-in. Slayton on it. She finds Serlenga. Into the middle it comes. Shannon MacMillan going outside, now putting on the brakes. This one goes right through, and there's Etta. 16th minute, USA leading 2-0. And as much as we talked about the USA squaring off against two of the minnows in the competition, how about Costa Rica? First they draw Brazil, then they draw the defending World Cup champs.
So what you have to do to develop your game, you got to play the best, and certainly they played two of the best in their first two games here at the Gold Cup.
Serlenga's pass to Parlow. Parlow is stopped, then knocked down. Lorrie Fair giving it up right side. Here is Christie Pearce. That one's cleared away. Back to the halfway line. Fawcett so steady in the center of that defense, going long, and on a short hop, it's right to the goalkeeper, Etta. Right-footed boot to the halfway line, met in the air by Chastain.
That's one of the positives of Brandi in the center of defense, is she is one of the best headers on the team.
Today they started initially with Chastain and Fawcett in the middle. Sobrero getting a rest today, at least in terms of not starting. You're allowed three subs, so we may see some of these players later on. It probably depends on the way this game goes. Here's Parlow giving it up right side. Long run by Bush toward the end line. Plays it right back to Fair. Instead, Whalen took the shot. It was blocked. Cleared out for a corner by Mercier. I think Fair was lining that one up, and then Whalen took it. There was another player that may have been able to take it, too.
Well, shows Susan Bush getting behind defenses. She finds the seam. It's a great ball, and Lorrie should be the one taking this. I think she expected to hit it until Sara actually took the shot.
MacMillan will take yet another corner for the United States. This time they'll play it short. Whalen cutting inside the box and then lost it.
Whalen getting the start at four, and lately for the United States, she's either played at the back or in the midfield, yet we know from her college days she can play up top.
She can play anywhere up and down the flank, and this gives her a great opportunity to attack the goal, use her speed. Even though she just dribbled it out of bounds, I like the aggressiveness to try to beat the Costa Rican team on the goal line.
Earlier today, Brazil was in action, taking on a Trinidad and Tobago team that lost 11-0 to the United States on Friday. Same thing happened at Trinidad and Tobago today. Katia had a brilliant game for Brazil. These two teams, Brazil and the United States, with goal differential in mind, will take on one another on Tuesday.
Right, the USA needs to win by 9 goals today to ensure that if Brazil and the USA tie, that they would still win the group.
This one's tackled away. A game will be played, by the way, in Foxborough. We'll have coverage for you here on ESPN and or ESPN2 throughout the tournament. Played upfield. There's Parlow right behind a couple of defenders. Defended by Contreras. Here's Parlow hooking it inside towards Whalen. It's blocked and cleared by Katia Madrid. Costa Rica coming back with it. On the left side, Nubia Duran. Down she goes, a USA foul.
Again, it's a foul, but it's also savvy. She knows she's not going to be able to outrun Christie Pearce.
Christie Pearce brought her down. 20th minute.
Little shoulder stuff, but she knows that she's not going to win this race. She goes down, she draws the foul.
So Costa Rica will have a free kick, the deepest free kick they've had so far today, going up against Jen Branham. Only the fourth cap for Jen. Just like in the men's game for the United States, the USA have so many great goalkeepers. Some you probably haven't even heard of in both levels, men's and the women's game. Free kick coming up. Man, 21st minute, USA up by a pair. It's taken forever for this free kick. Finally, Costa Rica will put it into play. And after all that, it's well over Branham. Didn't even have to make the save. Briseño took the shot. She's only 22 years old. 8th international appearance for her. Jen Branham puts it back into play. Knocked away by Costa Rica in the 21st minute, looking for some space up the middle. It's not there. Read by MacMillan. Down she goes. Madrid took her down. Pearce goes after it. Back to Jen Branham. Is that strong foot, Tony, you were talking about before?
Very comfortable playing the ball with her feet, and her teammates are going to use her every chance they get.
Fair. On that touch, it was given away. Headed up by Serlenga. MacMillan. No flag. Parlow going inside the middle. Shot at a goal by Susan Bush. Nice feed from Parlow. USA leads 3-0. Susan Bush with her second international goal.
Cindy Parlow bends that ball behind the defense. What's great about this, knowing Susan, that she takes it left-footed, and that shows some growth in her game. Watch this ball bend away from the goalkeeper. When Cindy hit it, she bends it so it drives between the defense and the goalkeeper, and Susan's just working hard to get in front of goal.
A little bit of role reversal, too. Bush has been playing on that right flank and trying to play balls across. This time, Parlow went out wide.
Well, that's one of the specialties of Cindy Parlow. She's very comfortable out in the flank. She's very comfortable taking players on.
And she sets up Susan Bush for the third USA goal. We're now in the 23rd minute. The USA has pulled away to a 3-goal lead. Bush, MacMillan, and Serlenga, the goal scorers. Bush's previous goal against the Czech Republic. Up the middle. The touch was made by Whalen and just cleared out for a corner. That frustrated the goalkeeper, Adam. She thought there could have been a much better play made there.
And I think Sara came central a bit too early. She needs to just keep some spacing there so Cindy has a bit more room in the center. But I like the way they're looking for each other.
Aguilar is up, looking like she may be coming in. The player down is Briseño. And they will bring out the training staff, apparently, to take a look. We're in the 24th minute, so put some stoppage time on the board.
Even though Costa Rica's down 3-0 and it's relatively early in the game, you can see that they're trying to play soccer. You can see they're trying to play within a concept of staying tight defensively. What's going to work against them, JP, is the fact that they're playing every other day, they're traveling on their off day, and they're just probably not fit enough to stay with the U.S. after having played Brazil just 2 days ago.
10 players in the field now for Costa Rica as MacMillan gets ready for the corner. Going inside. There was a mistake made in front. A lot of confusion. Headed up by Parlow. She had a few choices there, either to head that one up or play it down and then take the shot. You're watching the 2000 Women's Gold Cup from Louisville, Kentucky. Serlenga, MacMillan, and Bush all scoring. The first two goals just a couple of minutes apart. Be put back into play by Contreras. And then up the wing from Barantes. Possession is lost there. Here's Fawcett to Serlenga. Shannon MacMillan gets around Madrid. That's blocked. Costa Rica on the recovery. They've got possession of the 25th. They're still working on Briseño. In fact, right there on that sideline. USA with the big lead over Costa Rica early. Costa Rica on the free kick. Sent all the way across. And then it was lost there by Barantes. Here is Cindy Parlow. Parlow getting in deep, and then it's tackled away. We've got another player down. That is Contreras.
You see Cindy Parlow here. She's very comfortable taking on. Decent defense here. Goalkeeper comes. And it looks like a collision with the keeper and the number 12 player that has created the injury.
Now Contreras is bouncing up. 32 years of age. Only a couple of players are 30 or more for Costa Rica. It's a very young team.
I thought she did a pretty good job defensively there, JP. I thought the goalkeeper needed to come a bit earlier. But the fact that she came late, I think that's why Herrera's down now. Due to that collision with her own teammate.
Well, we may have a few minutes of stoppage time being put on. That's a second injury for Costa Rica. USA leading 3-0. They'll be taking on Brazil next. In fact, that'll be their stiffest test so far in this 2000 Gold Cup. You can see it Tuesday from Foxborough, 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific. Here on ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. More log on to ESPN.com, a part of the Go Network, Go.com. And it'll be nice to see the USA and Brazil again, Tony. They've developed into quite the rivalry.
It is an entertaining rivalry, JP. Both teams are attacking by nature. The Brazilians continue to evolve, and they've got great personalities all over their team. And the U.S., obviously, to stay ahead of Brazil is one of their goals, so it's going to be a wonderful, entertaining match.
Anna is apparently okay in goal. And we'll go back to play her position. And we'll resume play with a corner kick now in the 28th minute, but there was some extended time just put on there.
Expect to see one of these corner kicks end up in the back of the net. They've actually defended them pretty well. That's Costa Rica, but I see the U.S. now starting to pick them apart a bit.
Costa Rica still with the 10 players, playing across, and that goes out. I know you only have three subs, Tony, but you've got to make a decision pretty quick. You're down 3-0 like that. And that's a long time for her to be down.
Right, and you've probably got some young players that aren't real excited about getting in the game, but you've got to make a decision right on.
McMillan's pass was blocked. Here comes another. Played across toward Parlow. It's not a down. Coming through is Bush. I think that ball was out. Yeah, that's what the referee is saying.
Cindy did well to get her head on that ball.
28th minute, soon to be 29th, as Costa Rica gets ready to put it back into play. Down 3-0 to the defending World Cup champs.
Here comes that cross. You can see the ball just out of bounds, but she did really well to try to redirect that back into play.
Briseño has just come back on, so back to 11 aside.
You can see the U.S. here is playing a very low restraining line, letting them come out of their defensive shell and then trying to win the ball and counterattack in.
Sara Whalen now working the right side for the first time. Looking, playing it in low, was blocked by Costa Rica. Taken back on that left side and moved up by Laura Palma. Palma was over there defending as the ball goes out. USA wanted a foul. Instead, it was a Costa Rica throw-in. USA take it over, but only for a moment. Parlow deflects that. Whalen's over there. Now Parlow goes in strong and touched it out. USA leads 3-0. Throw in for Costa Rica. Laura Palma plays for the club side Saprissa, only 20 years old. Flicking it over Parlow. Fair came in on the challenge. Serlenga. Bush with a cut. Going outside, Slayton. Nice recovery for Slayton. Here's the cross, she hangs it up. Parlow couldn't get it. Instead, it's Whalen. Touching it back and giving it up. No one close enough to make that play. And a foul on Serlenga, bringing down Erica Castro.
Right now, the USA, some of these services are good services that are just not connecting. Here's the foul coming in from behind. That's Serlenga. But the services are good. The runs in the box need to be a bit better. They're hitting the far post area, and the players overrun that space.
Danielle Slayton taking it over. Serlenga keeping it on the ground at the middle. A couple of cuts by McMillan. Leads it for Parlow. That's cleared. Here is Slayton. And that's knocked away. Another throw in for the United States. Again, it's Danielle Slayton going inside. Parlow using some of that physical strength, but she couldn't win the ball. Costa Rica will take it on the turn. Castro picked off by the United States, and here they move forward again. Whalen going inside, looking for Parlow. That's blocked. Whalen will chase it. So will Madrid. And it's knocked out for a throw-in. Euro 2000 going on today. How about France over Spain, 2-1. Raul missed a PK in the 90th minute. And it was Holland all over Yugoslavia. Patrick Kluivert, huge day with 4 goals. So that means that Italy will be playing Holland in the next round. France and Portugal. Substitution. Briseño will leave, so apparently she wasn't fit to continue. They tried her out, and Lopez, Karina Lopez, gets her 9th cap. And Briseño is still limping from the previous injury. 32nd minute, USA up 3-0 over Costa Rica. Over the halfway line, Slayton lets it go out. It's a USA throw-in. Slayton's 16th appearance with the national team. Back for Chastain. One of several U.S. players now with over 100 caps. Serlenga will send it across. Flag goes up on the speedy Sara Whalen, who got caught a couple of times the other night.
It's probably due to the fact she hasn't been playing as much forward as, other positions, but she still has to be aware of her offside position. You can see her here, she's standing in an offside position. I don't even really think Costa Rica is trapping her. In fact, one player almost put her back on sides.
Costa Costa Rica will take it over. USA breaking it up. Taken back by Murcia. Madrid's going wide. Costa Rica stringing a few passes together, and then a tough challenge there. Palma went down, taken away as Duran could not advance into the USA box. Costa Rica losing possession. Here's Serlenga. Try to float that ball, finesse it through to Bush. It goes out.
Yeah, with Susan's speed, she wants to put it a bit more into space. I think she just underhit that. The idea was good.
USA on the ball. Cindy Parlow trying to get toward the middle. Push back out. Serlenga plays back. Halfway line. Chastain given away. This one is going to be cleared out by Costa Rica. USA will have it. Shannon MacMillan with one goal today, came in the 12th minute. Serlenga and Bush with the other goal scorers. MacMillan's pass, she lost it. Tries to fight her way back into the play. Costa Rica maybe with a chance here. Couldn't split those two defenders. Now on the right side, it was cleared away from Alvarez. That was the best Costa Rica had looked in the attack.
Well, the U.S. defense got caught a little bit flat, Shannon lost the ball in midfield, and they played it through.
Well, Costa Rica's going to make another change. Aguilar for Duran. And you got to wonder about the fitness maybe to make two subs as quickly as they did. You know Briseño was injured, but you wonder if there's something else too with a couple of games in 3 days.
Well, that's, as I said earlier, JP, is the concern. They don't have a lot of international matches, so therefore playing, traveling, and playing again against Brazil and the United States is a pretty demanding order.
Well, they've used up two of their allotted three in terms of subs. Corner kick coming up. Aguilar in only her second international match. Carmona's pass off that corner, and the shot taken is high. Jen Branham will put it back into play. Camila Lopez had the opportunity.
U.S. has to just get back to playing patient, moving the ball around, spreading out the Costa Rican defense, and opportunities will show up for them.
Coming all the way back to the other side. Branham with a long run. She just knocks it out, plays it safe. Throw-in coming up. Branham is a freshman, led the Carolina Tar Heels to another NCAA title last year. Carmona's throw-in. Costa Rica on the ball. Nearly 36 minutes gone here. First half of play with the USA leading 3-0. This ball goes up.
Good tackle by Lorrie Fair. In fact, two tackles in a row. Worked the ball back up to midfield.
Free kick coming up for Costa Rica. We can tell you that Shannon MacMillan has picked up a yellow card for dissent. We didn't see it. It was while we were away on a replay. And I'm guessing it may have gone back to a tackle that was made from before that wasn't called, and she may have done some arguing about it. But again, we didn't see it, but she does get the yellow.
Here the USA steps up as soon as this ball is played negative. And you can see they catch two Costa Rican players offside.
Branham with a long ball. Look out there. Edo was way out of goal and paid a price. Long run on that left side by Laura Palma. Christie Pearce is back for it. Didn't hit that one hard enough, but just barely enough to make it to Branham. Serlenga. Fawcett now shifting outside. Parlow wins it back. Serlenga. She got out of that in a hurry. That was well done by Serlenga. She appeared to be trapped on two or three occasions.
Right, good defense by Costa Rica in the midfield. Early on, she was getting too much space, and she was carving them apart, and now they've adjusted to that, which is good coaching and organization on their part.
Barantes off the throw. This will come to the near side. Chastain hits it back to Branam. Jen Branham's only 19 years old. Another 19-year-old slate going long. No communication back there. Costa Rica almost gave up at least a chance back there to defend was Murcia.
Well, again, good probing ball by Danielle Slayton, but I'm wondering if they build, can they get more out of it? And I think at this point, trying to get Cindy Parlow behind the defense is a little bit different than getting a Susan Bush or a Sarah Whalen behind the defense.
Emilia Carmona, the club team Herediano. That one's broken up, but it'll roll out. Costa Rica will have possession. Bush already has one goal today. Came in the 22nd minute, her second international goal. She's a name to remember in terms of the future of U.S. soccer. Maybe when the Hams, the Lilies, etc., no longer play internationally, it may take that long.
Well, I think we're seeing a lot of potential future stars out here for the U.S. Certainly Susan is one of them.
Here's the cross. Looked more like a shot that went away. MacMillan may have just missed hit.
Yeah, she's not happy with that. USA seemed to have slipped back into Costa Rican level game here, and they've got to get it back. They need at least one more goal before the half.
Headed up by the United States and taken over by Costa Rica. Serlenga went down and the foul was called. Free kick, U.S. We invite you to join us for the LPGA Tour, the ShopRite LPGA Classic on Friday, 2 Eastern, 11 a.m. Pacific time. Siri Pak will be on hand trying to defend her title. U.S. advancing into the box. MacMillan crossing it. Bush couldn't get there in time. The shot is deflected. Cleared out by Costa Rica. Sent away by Lopez. And back to the halfway line. Serlenga's pass to Slayton. 40 minutes gone. USA up by 3. Parlow couldn't get it. Didn't have to. Whalen's there. Now it's taken over by Palma. And cleared out. Christie Pearce on that far side with a throw-in. Tackle away from MacMillan. Be another throw-in coming up for the United States national team. Again, it's Pearce throwing down to Whalen. Whalen's pass toward Parlow, block. Parlow's down and still almost was able to make a play and at least advance that ball forward. U.S. trying to push it out wider to Bush. Cut off there by Barantes. Doesn't see the help coming with Fair. It's knocked away. Throw in U.S.
A good run down the flank by Sara Whalen. And a good near post run by Cindy Parlow. But I'll tell you what, the Costa Rican defender was right with her and broke up the play.
Slayton going long near post, headed down once, then played to the feet of Bush. And it's cleared away. 42nd minute. Costa Rica on the ball. Going out wide and the offside flag goes up. Second time they've been offside. Keep it here at halftime. We'll have a little feature on Brandi Chastain, plus our first half highlights. Goal scorers so far, Serlenga, MacMillan, and Bush. USA up by 3, 42nd minute. Pearce on the run. As deep as she's gone today, cutting it back, and it's blocked. And cleared away. They gave Pearce too much room.
Well, it's good to see her come forward. I think that's one of the things she did so well against Trinidad and Tobago.
On that far side, taken back by Costa Rica. Possession was lost to the United States. Serlenga. Now it's switched by the U.S. Slayton. Parlow leads it. Slayton to the end line for this cross. And Whalen was in a bit deep.
knocked out. USA's ball.
Shannon MacMillan has to fight to get into the penalty area a little bit quicker. And I think she's holding herself back, probably because she's not as familiar with that position. But these are opportunities for her if she gets on the weak post. This is what you see Foudy and Lily do so well and end up with goals.
MacMillan with a throw-in, near side. The turn, the pass intended for Bush was blocked. Taken back by Palma and cleared, but cleared out.
Probably a good non-call on the potential handball there by Costa Rica.
USA will play it back toward the halfway line. Slate, left side. Intended for Bush. She'll have to come back for it. All the way back it comes. Chastain, Serlenga, Slate, now Fair. Lorrie Fair, couple of cuts inside. Blocked by Barantes, who clears. Slayton hangs it up. 44th minute. Millen gets over there. She has Whalen with her. Whalen drops back now into a hole. It goes to Sarah Whalen. Serlenga to Whalen. Trying to find MacMillan outside wide. Chastain. A blast the time. Over Anna. One of the veterans of this team, now 31 years old, and another one of those converted forwards. She was a gifted striker in her day.
Well, she still is, but she's also a gifted soccer player who can play anywhere on the field. And she gave us a great boost in the Olympic year with her sophistication and her ability to play out of the back.
Harlow got whacked. You don't want to give up free kicks to the United States or any good team from this close to goal. Dead center, too.
If Cindy holds the ball up here pretty good and gets fouled, I think this is MacMillan territory, so let's see what happens.
For Costa Rica, time to get organized quickly.
My guess is either MacMillan or Chastain are going to get an opportunity here.
First, Serlenga's assisting and getting the ball back to 10 yards. So they've got Fawcett, Fair, MacMillan, and Chastain. The referee's only going to add on a couple of minutes of stoppage time. It could have been more. With a couple of injuries here. Couple of stepovers, then a pass through. What a set piece. Chastain played it in front. It's knocked out.
Well, that fooled me. Did it fool you, Coach?
Well, it was well conceived. What you see here is there's no one on the end in the free space on the Costa Rica wall. So Brandy's able to run into a space that's unmarked. And they saw what they had, and they took it, and it was a pretty exciting little free kick.
Eighth corner for the U.S. Looking for a goal. But it went wide. Serlenga that time in the air. Nearly a minute gone in stoppage time.
Watch Nikki Serlenga's run here. She bends it away, so now she's attacking from that far post area and doesn't put it on goal, but gets a good piece of it.
We're in the second minute of stoppage time. USA 3, Costa Rica no score. You're watching Gold Cup 2000 today on ESPN2. Played up to Parlow. Cindy Parlow will chase it down towards the corner flag. She did well to keep it in play. The strength of Parlow in evidence. Broken up in the end, and Parlow goes and fights too hard to win it back. She gets called.
She gets called, but that's one of Cindy's best qualities, is she's got a real good defensive bite for a front runner. I think she uses that left arm here, kind of swings that Costa Rican defender around. But if she gets away with it, she's going to get a chance to serve the penalty area.
Free kick, Costa Rica, with time running out in the first half. Lorrie Fair looking for it. Serlenga, one another tackle, but then lost possession to Aguilar. All the way back to Branam. Jen Branam walks it up. Well, that'll do it.
They almost went to 2.5 minutes of stoppage time. USA made six changes, and they've got a 3-0 lead at halftime.
Well, I think that they started off the game very sharply. They were getting behind Costa Rica. They made their opportunities and then seemed to slip back. And now I think at halftime, April Heinrichs will convince them that they've got to get at least six more goals.
Well, Shannon MacMillan was one of the USA vets who scored. Otherwise, it was youth serving it up with Serlenga and Bush scoring. USA leads 3-0 here in the Gold Cup.
Sonata, with front and side airbags, V6 power, and a generous list of features, including the ability to leave it all behind. The Sonata, from Hyundai, with the freedom of America's best warranty plan. From AYSO to the World Cup, Hyundai is proud to support soccer.
What?
It's funny how you always come down here to clean it up, and then it never gets clean. I just can't figure it out.
But like, she still can't figure it out.
Yeah, all right.
For the great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down. Make it a Bud Light.
Before a Select ball leaves the factory, it must pass an inspection like no other in the world. For flight trajectory, surface abrasion, stitch resiliency, and a perfectly consistent bounce. Some balls, however, are chosen by Chief Inspector Anna Lenkoven for a more extreme set of tests. Her procedures are somewhat confidential.
8 countries, 160 women going toe-to-toe to be the first Gold Cup winner. So much for world peace. The action of the first ever Women's Gold Cup soccer tournament. For tickets, call 877-407-TICKS or visit womensgoldcup.com.
Mr. Jordan, you ever see Shamiqua Holtz ball play?
She's not bad.
Not bad? Talking about the... Oh, girl's got crazy skills. Crossover dribble, find a hole. Before you can even say you go, girl, she's gone. She's even drinking your stuff. Gatorade. Carb replacing electrolyte. You're the nectar of the athlete. Oh. Hey, Mikey, what do you think about this? If I could be like Meek...
Come here. Come here. Come here.
Yeah, sure. Right. Sure.
That's very funny, Mike. Come on.
Welcome back, everyone. The USA leads Costa Rica 3-0 here in the 2000 Women's Gold Cup. You know, it was just about a year ago that Brandi Chastain became a household name thanks to a huge penalty kick. Let's all take a look back. The USA could win the World Cup on this next kick. Chastain will take it.
I wasn't nervous at all when I took the kick. I mean, not for a second. But every time I see it on film or on tape, I just have this, like, I don't know what it is, but because I think every time I see it, the ball seems closer and closer to the post. And how it could have easily gone on the other side. And then I think, okay, Brandi, it went in the goal, so just relax.
Goal! There were no nerves from Chastain that hot July afternoon when she coolly converted a PK and sent the Rose Bowl into a red, white, and blue frenzy. The World Cup win capped a national love affair with the U.S. women's team, bringing Brandi and her teammates unprecedented attention.
I had no idea that people would react the way they did to the World Cup.
Basically, since the World Cup, we've just been really busy. A lot of free meals, which is always great.
You know, I've made it when a chef in New York stops me to talk about women's soccer. You know, that's really phenomenal.
For Chastain and company, life as world champs meant magazine covers and TV commercials.
Watch it. Brandi's in the house.
Plenty of interviews and even more autographs. Soccer celebrity also brought recognition in some surprising places.
I rarely would go to a park and there would be a pickup soccer game. And all of a sudden I see all these people start coming up to the soccer field and think, oh, this is cool, you know, they're gonna start kicking the ball around. And they start talking, but they're not speaking English.
And I realize, oh, it's French. And so they look over and they say, do you want to play? I'm thinking, ah, look at the feel. I'm thinking, I don't want to twist my ankle or anything like that. I mean, it's all guys, you know? And I said, okay, well, sure, no problem. And they say, what's your name? And I said, Brandi. And they're just all of a sudden start going, I hear Coupe du Monde, right? I'm like, oh my God, no way. So they start talking about the World Cup, and it was just like, I'm just impressed that people know about it. I really am. I think that's, for me, that's the most important. Not that we get all the sponsorship or, you know, go here and go there, but that people actually paid attention and are really impressed with the product that we put on the field.
For the first time ever, Wimbledon is on TNT. Get set for 2 weeks of the best tennis on television. Agassi, Sampras, the Williams sisters. Wimbledon on TNT, where every point can truly make or break a champion. Watch TNT Monday, June 26th through Friday, July 7th. The preeminent tennis championships in the world have a new home. Wimbledon is on TNT.
This 4th of July, TBS has Steven, Jackie, Sly, and of course, Pauly Shore.
For the best action, tune into the Superstation. Take a look.
I'll be back. Don't miss the 4th of July movies on the Superstation all day long.
Back.
It's MLS. They've taken over the network.
Get me the control room now.
This is Jones.
What are you doing
in my control room?
We've got your anchors. We want Saturdays and our own show. We're the number one sport in the world. We deserve to be seen.
I don't think I'm gonna make you guys. I gotta go to the bathroom.
All right, who else has to go?
MLS Extra Time, Mondays at 11 on ESPN2.
Soccer's where I met Tracy.
I met Felix.
We all play together.
We have fun together.
He's the coolest.
My nickname is Bigfoot.
Goalie Queen.
They call me Bulldog because I'm really aggressive.
Soccer makes me feel pumped up.
It gets you stronger.
It makes me feel great.
Soccer's when I run faster than anyone.
I could play forever.
Soccer Saturday continues on ESPN with the Colorado Rapids leading scorer Junior Agogo takes his team to D.C. to do battle with D.C. United. Then on ESPN2, the Galaxy are in Dallas for their matchup with the Burn at 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific on ESPN and ESPN2, the worldwide leader in sports. In Louisville, Kentucky, we'll be coming back with some highlights and some second half action. You're watching the 2000 Women's Gold Cup. USA leads Costa Rica 3-0.
Before a select ball leaves the factory, it must pass an inspection like no other in the world. For flight trajectory, surface abrasion, stitch resiliency, and a perfectly consistent bounce. Some balls, however, are chosen by Chief Inspector Anna Lankoven for a more extreme set of tests. Her procedures are somewhat confidential.
Nothing is better than the freedom.
Every Hyundai comes with the freedom of America's best warranty plan. So for the next 10 years, instead of worrying about your car, worry about other things, like the SPF of your sunscreen. The Sonata from Hyundai. Nothing
is better. From AYSO to the World Cup, Hyundai is proud to support soccer.
8 countries, 160 women going toe-to-toe to be the first Gold Cup winner. So much for world peace. Come see the action of the first ever Women's Gold Cup soccer tournament. For tickets, call 877-407-TICKS or visit womensgoldcup.com.
Well, it took a little longer for the USA to get the offense started compared to Friday night. Sara Whalen would end up finding Nikki Serlenga for the game's first goal.
Nikki hammers assist into the side netting there. Sara Whalen gets the assist. And Sara Whalen gets the next assist, giving it off to Shannon MacMillan, who bends it into the far post area. And then Cindy Parlow bends one behind the defense to a Susan Bush, who slashes in and tucks it away.
3-0 USA. Tony, these numbers not as lopsided certainly as Friday night.
Well, I think that's partly because Costa Rica's doing a good job defensively, but the USA needs more than 5 shots on goal, JP.
And the USA may make some changes for the second half, which will be coming your way soon. Meanwhile, in the first half, thanks to goals by Serlenga, MacMillan, and Bush, the USA leads Costa Rica by the score of 3-0. Keep it here for more Gold Cup 2000 action on ESPN2.
WNBA fans, don't miss this special offer. Now you can order WNBA season pass at the early bird price of 2 payments of $19.50. Just call the number on your screen to order. With WNBA season pass, you'll be able to see up to 60 games of thrilling WNBA action. Plus, you'll get NBA.com TV, the NBA's new 24-hour network. So don't miss this special offer. Call this number to order now. WNBA season pass is in demand.
For the first time on television,
you go public and nothing will ever be the same again.
An insider ready to speak the truth.
I want to go on the record right now.
A reporter will help him reveal it.
Does he go on television and tell the truth? Yes.
The story that couldn't be killed is in demand.
Are we gonna air it?
Witness one man's courage and conviction. Al Pacino, Russell Crowe, The Insider, a Michael Mann film. In demand, pay-per-view for the demanding viewer. You rule.
This week, the LPGA Tour rolls into Atlantic City, where the stakes are always high, but the low score wins the trophy. The ShopRite LPGA Classic begins Friday at 2 on ESPN2.
Mr. Jordan, you ever see Shamiqua Holtzclaw play?
She's not bad.
Not bad? Talking about the claw. Girl's got crazy skills. Crossover dribble, by the hole. Before you can even say you go, girl, she's gone. She's even drinking your stuff. Gatorade. Carb replacing electrolyte. You're the nectar of the athlete. Gah! Hey, Mikey, what do you think about this? If I could be like Meek.
Come here.
Yeah, sure. That's
very funny, Mike. Come on.
Sonata, with front and side airbags, V6 power, and a generous list of features, including the ability to leave it all behind. The Sonata, from Hyundai, with the freedom of America's best warranty plan.
From AYSO to the World Cup, Hyundai is proud to support soccer.
8 countries, 160 women going toe-to-toe to be the first Gold Cup winner. So much for world peace. The action of the first ever Women's Gold Cup soccer tournament. For tickets, call 877-407-TICKS or visit womensgoldcup.com.
The 2000 Women's Gold Cup is being brought to you by IFS, the soccer marketers. By Hyundai, from AYSO to the World Cup, Hyundai is proud to support soccer. And by Bud Light, With a great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light. Second half underway with the USA leading Costa Rica by the score of 3-0, and the USA has made some changes. You see one of them there, number 22, Christie Welsh.
Looks like Christie Welsh is in for Cindy Parlow.
Told Julie Foudy would make an appearance here as well in the second half of play. Again, you're allowed three subs, which really doesn't help the weaker teams in this competition. Costa Rica have already made a couple of changes. This ball rolls up. Looked like it was all the way out. Now they're going to say it is. Near side throw-in.
It's good work by Shannon MacMillan to keep that ball alive and earn a throw-in deep in Costa Rica territory.
To the near side. It's flicked to the middle. And it's straight up. And it's caught in goal. There is Julie Fine, who comes on. Got the captain's armband on.
Number 22, Christie Welsh.
Julie Foudy in for Lorrie Fair in the center of midfield.
Here comes a shot by Welsh that's blocked. And now cleared away. USA with it. Pushed up. Fair and Parlow, the two that have left. Crossed inside and swatted away from goal. Near side. Right in front, and a goal! USA with their fourth goal. Christie Welsh, all she does, Tony, is score goals.
Well, April Heinrichs has to be very pleased with her goal production this year. She comes in, she gets her first touch, I think, of the ball. I think she got one head in before this, and it's in the back of the net. She positions herself perfectly in the front post area. In fact, she repositions herself to get away from those defenders and then just hits it square into the near post.
Well, when I say all she does is score goals, I mean that as a positive. She's got other parts of her game she has to work on, but how do you ignore somebody that can score whenever she plays?
You don't. You don't. She's making a statement. A good ball played in by Susan Bush, and Christie Welsh just puts it away, gives the USA a 4-0 lead.
We're talking about a young lady, 19 years old, 14th international appearance and already with 10 goals. That's a strike rate that's Mia Hamish.
Very impressive.
Another injury. Perhaps that's Madri's. It's been a rough day for Costa Rica, injury-wise. A lot of bumps and bruises on their second day of competition.
What's most impressive about Christie is that she's not needing a bushel full of chances to score goals. And usually young players, even scoring phenoms, need so many chances before they can stick one in the net. She's taking one, two, or three chances and making one a goal.
Foudy from Slayton. Sending it across. Long run, right side. Caught up to, but in the end, that ball was out. Christie Pearce made the run.
Still, I like that ball played across. Christie should be getting into the attack here.
Aguilar is throwing. Lopez played it back. And it's picked off. Slayton now closer to the middle. Now she hustles back to play some defense. She gets some help there from Chastain. Pearce. Pushed up the middle. It was deflected. Long run, and Bush won't be able to get it. That goes out of play.
I think it's a corner.
Era was trying to save it from being a corner kick. USA leads 4-0. Four different individuals scoring goals, unlike the other night when Parlow had the hat trick and a couple of others had a couple of goals each. Played across, and that header went just wide. Julie Foudy, right place, right time, just center wide.
What a good corner by Shannon MacMillan. She drives it across. Joy Fawcett looks for it, but Julie Foudy just can't get herself in front of that defender to tuck it home.
50th minute, USA up by four. Their second game of this Gold Cup Tuesday, they meet Brazil at Foxborough Stadium. Collected now by Costa Rica. And Slayton will get called for that foul on the side. She brought down Jacqueline Alvarez. Free kick, Costa Rica. Right at the halfway line. Lifted up. Right sideline. Alvarez lost that ball out. Daniel Slate just finished a freshman or sophomore year, I should say, at Santa Clara. That's another women's soccer powerhouse.
But there's at least three Santa Clara players or former players in the lineup: Serlenga, Chastain, and Danielle Slayton.
Up the middle. Foudy's long ball. Good run left side. Sara Whalen's got the speed to get it. She's shot it wide. That's the way she wants that ball played, the leader.
Sara gets in behind the defense. Maybe she needs to try to get that across to Christie. But good ball by Julie Foudy. I think she has a little space there where she can slot it across. You can see Christie Welsh and Susan Bush on the back post area.
52nd minute. USA up over Costa Rica by four. If you're just joining us, Serlenga, MacMillan, Bush, and Welsh, the goal scores. It was 3-0 at halftime. Welsh's goal came just a couple of minutes into the start of this half. On the turnaround, that one's blocked. And cleared. USA fighting to get it back, and they do. Welsh, nice turn. MacMillan heads it up. Not a down. There's Anna.
JP, right now, the two wing forwards for the USA are not creating width quick enough. They're backing into width instead of bending runs into the wide area so these center midfielders can find them in space.
Bush is chasing this ball. Forces a giveaway, a turnover there deep in Costa Rica zone. It gives the USA a throw-in deep. 25-year-old Shannon MacMillan gets ready for this. A couple of bounces, and then the clearance by Costa Rica. Not a great clearance, but it's out of there. Foudy nods it down to Slate. Cutting it back for Julie Foudy, former Stanford All-American. That one's given away. Carmona. And coming back for it was Serlenga. Fawcett. Finding the open player right, Christy Pearce out of Monmouth University. A couple of nice steps there by MacMillan. Foudy across. Slayton inches forward to Serlenga. Perfect opportunity for that give and go. Left side, Slayton in the box. Trying to cut it back. Susan Bush on the turn. Give it up to Serlenga. What a goal! Great passing all around in the USA. Have a 5-0 lead.
You're right, JP. That is a good passing attack. And I'll tell you, you can already see the experience of Julie Foudy as she spreads the game. But here's a good little touch. And Serlenga, number two for the USA for her today.
Well, Bush had the opportunity to turn and shoot on her own, but one of the great attributes of this team, the unselfishness.
Just keep finding the open player. In this case, the easy play is to find Serlenga facing the goal, and Nikki does the same thing she did in the first half, finds the corner at the back of the net.
Well, we know a lot about Nikki Serlenga as a playmaker, but she's put on quite a finishing touch today.
Well, she's impressing me, and I know she's impressing Coach Heinrichs. That's what she needs to do. She's in a hunt for the Olympic team birth.
This one is going to be an offside on Sara Whalen.
Danielle does great to get all the way to the end line here. She cuts it back in that seam, and then Susan Bush just finds the free player. Nikki, with a little bit of the outside of the foot bend, gets the corner.
USA, back of the ball. Coming inside, and that one went wide. Bush was looking for her second goal of the game.
Right, she needs to look for her own goals. That's a case where she's hitting it to the correct post, try to beat her on the far post area. Just didn't get it where she wanted to.
Costa Rica will have the ball.
Good start for the USA, JP, in this half. They need to score some goals. They want to have that advantage, so a tie against Brazil puts them through to the first place of the group and conceivably avoids playing China in the semifinal. They need four more to accomplish that.
Our The throw in near side. Shannon MacMillan plays it back. Foudy up the middle. Touched over by Serlenga to MacMillan. MacMillan, one of the Olympic and World Cup heroes for the U.S. team, will play it across. Doesn't make it. Blocked and cleared. Up for Castro. And away from the referee, it goes to number 13, Carmona. Slayton got beaten by that pass. She comes back to defend. Offside. Costa Rica, one of the few times today for them.
You see the experience of Chastain right there. The runner is just running vertically. Brandi sees the serve about to happen, just takes two steps forward. Easy call for the assistant referee.
Off the Chastain feed. Foudy going wide. Danielle Slayton brings it back. Julie Foudy will switch. Christie Pearce. And that one's knocked out of play. USA with another throw-in. 57th minute. Whalen comes over to take it. Former University of Connecticut All-American. Here's MacMillan scooping it up. Headed down by Bush. She's got it back. Bush will push it backward. Chastain advances. Give and go. Chastain still in. Now lost it on that last touch inside the box. Collected by Foudy. Susan Bush. Whalen held up a runner, or at least tried to, so she would not be offside, but it still didn't work.
Yeah, she's got to work on that. She's killing some of the attacks here with her offsides.
You talked about that the other night. Is it from a sense of not having played that position in a while?
It's a sense of not having played that position. It's a sense of not taking your looks. And she just has to do a better job.
Back live, you can hear the woodwork. Here's a turnaround shot. Saved in front and clear. The defense helped out that time.
Great save off the line.
Brought back down by the USA. They almost got their sixth goal. A miss by Costa Rica there. USA will control right. MacMillan is blocked. Taken back on the left side. And then cleared. Slayton will play it up. Here's Serlenga. USA still with it. Going inside the box, not high enough. Costa Rica will get it back, and here they come. Costa Rica will push it back. 59th minute, down 5-0.
Watch the shot by Welsh, cleared by the defender off the line. This is where goalkeepers have to wine and dine the defenders when they make plays like that.
Give credit to Katia Madriz, otherwise it would have been a 6-0 game. Carmona for Costa Rica, pushing it up. There's some room on the left side. Castro cuts it back. The shot was blocked. Fawcett clears to Foudy. Serlenga. Nice run. The keeper came on. That was a mistake. Whalen played it back. And it just got wide of Bush. Well, Era almost had to pay for that mistake. When she came out, she gave the USA an advantage with the net empty. Costa Rica back with the ball.
It was a good play by Sara Whalen. She made the good pass in there. A little unlucky not to get her third assist of the game.
Whalen is wide. This one goes out of play. You're watching some Group A action today. Meanwhile, in Group B yesterday, Zhang Guying had four goals in China's romp over Guatemala. And then Canada over Mexico. How about Christine Sinclair? She just turned 17. She had a couple of goals in the Canada win. She's a player to watch.
Yeah, she's a bright player for Canadian future.
Right sideline for Costa Rica, and here they come. May have another injury. It's going to be the USA's ball. Costa Rica have a player down. Referee's whistle will stop play.
You can see here, I think she might get stepped on a bit. A little bit of tugging and pulling there going on.
USA's ball when we continue. And it's Slayton again on the throw-in.
Can't say enough how Julie Foudy has set a tempo here for the distribution of the ball out of the midfield for the USA. I think that's one reason why they're attacking from so many different positions.
Fawcett's pass up.
Don't drip it on the field.
Foudy. All the way across for Slayton. Down the side, that's stopped by the goalkeeper. And it will clear. Halfway line, won that time by Chastain. Chasing it was Foudy, pushing it back, and now it's deflected out. We have WNBA action for you coming up on Monday, 7 Eastern, 4 Pacific. The LA Sparks and Lisa Leslie versus the Washington Mystics, led by the great Shamiqua Holzclaw. WNBA here on ESPN. This one's deflected out of the box. USA with Serlenga looking for the hat trick, and that was cleared away again by a defender in front. USA can set up shop again, much deeper. They've got a 5-0 lead, 62nd minute.
Look for the short corner right here.
Good call. Here's Whalen. Millen going inside the box, lofting it high. That was a pass inside, but it just went wide. They were looking. Serlenga trying to get involved in a combination play in the box.
Serlenga's been active. She had another chance there, two chances in the last 30 seconds to get her hat trick.
Foul on the USA. Costa Rica's ball, 62nd minute. Jessica Mercia in the middle. All the way across, left side. No one's blocked. Aguilar will chase. MacMillan's got it to Foudy. Up the middle. Serlenga got cut off by Mercia defensively. Pearce headed it back. That's well done.
That is well done, JP. If that ball drops, it becomes a much more difficult ball for the defense to clear.
Instead, here's the USA countering all the way up. There's the chip, but it's too high. Susan Bush. But how quickly defense, that play by Pearce, leads to an offensive attack at the other end in a matter of what, 2-3 seconds?
That's right, especially with the speed and the dynamic players that are in the USA lineup right now. Again, Foudy picked up that ball, one pass, and Bush is almost behind the defense.
Up the middle feed. Here is Welsh, cutting it back. Foudy. Second half sub for the U.S. Making a lot happen here in the second half of play. Foudy again.
You can see the width right now. There's no one out there in the width, so the attack is pretty central. But hey, great goal. Guess who?
Serlenga took that shot. Somehow it made it through. USA in a romp. Nikki Serlenga's got the hat trick.
Well, I'll tell you what, she's finding the corner with everything she hits from out front. Full credit to her. Hits it well. I think the keeper may have been screened a bit, but even if she isn't screened, that ball's headed for the corner. One bounce and into the side netting. Little touch to free herself up, and then back in the other direction.
Well, she's auditioning for the Olympics, and what an audition it is. Getting a lot of playing time today, making it count. She had a pretty good game the other night when she came off.
She did, and she's playing with confidence, and that's what you got to have at this level. You got to believe in yourself, and obviously she's showing that she belongs on the Olympic roster.
Well, she has some confidence too. She'll play it back to Serlenga. There's the flick. Well, three players involved in that, including Bush at the end, but Nikki Serlenga with a hat trick.
Here's the goal again. Look at Serlenga dribbling it towards her right, driving it back to her left, one bounce and into the side netting. That's a great goal.
Oh, yeah, the Parlow hat trick on Friday. You've got a Serlenga hat trick tonight.
You know, I had a call from Lynn Morgan from the WUSA Atlanta team, and she was all excited about what Cindy Parlow's doing. I think she's going to be calling me again about Serlenga because they're both assigned to the Atlanta team.
Here is Foudy. Of course you are right now anyway, the acting commissioner of that new league, which will start next year. We'll be talking about that during the Gold Cup. You will see not only some of the U.S. players, but hopefully some of the people that play for China, Brazil, and some of the other powers all coming here next year. Very calm, relaxed USA bench. How often do you see Christine Lilly sitting in?
Same thing I was going to say, JP. You don't often see Christine Lilly sitting on the bench. She's been such a presence in the U.S. for so long, the USA lineup.
Well, playing so many games, 32 games up to the Olympics, it's important to not burn players out. So if you can give a Lilly and a Ham and a rest and win the game handily, why not, especially now?
Absolutely. I think April Hines is doing exactly what she needs to do. This schedule this year could be very grinding unless she kind of portions it out to players.
Foudy will play it up. USA leads 6-0. Half of the goals scored by Nikki Serlenga, who came into the match with only two, so internationally, so she has increased that output. More goals today than she had coming in her first 11 games. Fawcett. Joy Fawcett with the clearance. Here's a quick touch upfield. He was going into space. Whalen tried to run it down. Good second effort. She got a piece, not all. Costa Rica playing it back in the box. That's broken up. More urgency on the part of the USA here in the second half. As you had mentioned before, it was dying down at the end of the first half. 2000 Women's Gold Cup coming in from Louisville, Kentucky on ESPN2. There are your goal scorers. The girl up top, Serlenga, has scored three times.
From a holding midfield position. So that defensive posture in that position still works when you can come forward and get some great service.
Costa Rica offside again here now in the 68th minute.
Now you see a little bit of their naivety as far as running forward and just running themselves off sides.
Costa Rica back with the ball, down 6-0 here. Right up the middle, no room there. Partially blocked by MacMillan. Taken down by Madriz. Made a nice play off the line to stop one ball from going into the back of the net. That was several minutes ago. USA will come back to collect this. They'll play it back to Branham. She knew that one was coming. She clears. USA back with the ball. And that one is floated into space. Nobody close enough to it. Lopez is there. Lopez came on as a sub earlier. Back for Mercier. That pass is blocked. USA getting it back. They've got a 6-0 lead, 69th minute. This one's blocked, and Costa Rica will try on the counter. Headed back by Chastain to Branham.
Good cover by Brandi Chastain, but a little sloppy right now for the USA. They just got to get a hold of the ball, knock it around, especially since Costa Rica is trying to go forward more. Some openings behind them should appear.
MacMillan blocked. Taken over. And cleared by Costa Rica. And another flag. We've been called a few times now. More than a few. First, they weren't even pushing forward enough to get called for the offside.
Now here's the offside again. She's trying to stay on the offside line there, but she's just in her attacking half. And what's happening is with the confidence that USA has in Jen Branham to cover that space, they're able to hold that position a little bit longer. They have the same confidence in Suri Molinix. And Costa Rica's finding themselves in an offside position as the ball's played.
Yet another corner for the United States. MacMillan will take it again. 70th minute. Double figures in terms of corners. Number 11 for the USA. MacMillan. She may have taken them all. Played across. Knotted down partially as Chastain. Not enough on that shot. Another try. That's blocked. Third back by Whalen. Pearce. Sara Whalen. Takes the look up, sends the long ball on a diagonal path. Here's a turnaround shot. A left wide from Bobby.
What a good ball by Sara Whalen here, that long diagonal ball. But guess who ended up out on the flank? And this is what the attacking midfielders in this system have to do. They have to drift wide and balance on the outside. I know Julie Foudy would like to have this one back. She has the keeper beating near post. She's looking near post and just hits it wide.
I remember when I said the stats weren't as lopsided as the other night. They are now, but Costa Rica's had a couple of shots, but they've given away some 23 for the U.S., and a lot of those on target for the USA. Six of them have found their way to the back of the net. Costa Rica yet to have a shot on goal. USA have had 10. So almost half of their shots, which most coaches would take that ratio, especially the goals. ESPN Classic invites you to join us tonight for 28 years of Title IX. It starts at 9 p.m. Eastern Time. It's a special documentary. We hope you enjoy it. And if you'd like to order ESPN Classic, dial up 1-800-CLASSIC or call your cable provider. This ball is cleared away by Costa Rica. This portion of the match being brought to you commercial-free by IFS.
But some of the play of these young players, JP, the decision by April Heinrichs and the coaching staff is going to be very difficult. Remember, there's an 18-player roster for the Olympics.
Well, just like you had, there's always going to be the one or the two players that you wish you had a spot for, and you don't.
Absolutely right. Remember, Scurry, Akers, and Overbeck aren't playing in this event. Then you got players like Welsh, Whalen, Bush, Serlenga. The list can go on and on. So it's going to be a very, very difficult decision.
Throw in coming up for Costa Rica.
Where Serlenga is kind of making a pretty good statement on where she should be come September in the Olympic roster.
Costa Rica on the ball, 72 minutes gone. USA leading 6-0. Another strong showing today, as you would expect, against a lesser experienced team. But this damage was done, really, with a lot of younger, lesser experienced players for the USA. Six lineup changes from the other night, personnel-wise. USA attacking with more. Eric came out to take it away from Bush. And Eric clears. Welsh was looking for room in the box as well. And Eric is down.
Well, she knocked it out of bounds to give herself some time here. But this is where Susan is not confident going to her left. And she should have taken this player on a lot earlier, but she wants to beat her to the inside to her right foot. And so is waiting, and now runs out of space behind that defender. The goalkeeper can come out and win the ball.
How much do you work on repetition, Tony, if a player like Bush needs to get stronger, let's say, on the left side?
Well, she never walked by the... When we had our training camp in Florida in 90... Nine. She never walked by the wall without having a ball so that she could take some knocks with her left foot. I know Lauren Gregg spent a lot of time with her. She's gotten better. She scored a goal with her left foot today. It's something that she needs to continue to improve on. But remember, JP, we've seen some great players that have never used their left foot. Beckenbauer comes to mind.
This was Welsh, or Megan Bush, I'm sorry, coming through. Welsh was freer on the other side. We're in the 74th minute. Harris had a rough day. But I'll tell you what, she has faced some of the best attacking players in the world the last couple of days. She didn't see Mia Hamm, of course, or Lily or Milbrook, but she has seen some good scores from the United States, but also the Brazilian team that faced her the other night. Very strong team as well.
It's like a crash course in goalkeeping. But she may still see a Milbrook, a Hamm. I think the USA has one more sub. A Lily, somebody else may end up coming in.
Portion of the match being brought to you commercial free by Hyundai.
And remember, JP, even though the team has looked impressive here, the USA cannot be satisfied unless they do enough to give them the advantage in goal difference going into that Brazil game. And that means three more goals.
Head-to-head being the first tiebreaker, so obviously if the USA and Brazil tie, they would have identical records. If either side win, obviously they would win the group.
Oh, they're both going to try to win, but if they do end up in a tie, the team with the better goal difference will win the group and conceivably avoid China in the semifinal.
Costa Rica back of the ball near the halfway line. We won't see any overtime in these games until the semifinals. Here's Whalen, and and she just lost it out.
Yeah, she needs to get a hold of that ball earlier, make her first touch right at that defender and go at her, because she has the ability to do that and beat that defender every time.
76th minute, USA up 6-0 over Costa Rica. Christy Pearce ready for the throw-in. 25-year-old played it up. Knocked back, and then given away by the U.S. on the Welsh pass. Costa Rica's ball from the near side. Emilia Carmona. She subbed against Brazil the other night. Tonight she started. Aguilar instead will take the throw. Aguilar plays it back. Madrid.
USA has dropped off. Their restraining line is, up near midfield. They're letting possession happen here, and they're going to look to counterattack when they can dispossess in the midfield.
Garcia's pass. Looked like it was going to be too far. Still might be. Not enough gas in the tank there. Ball just getting away from Erica Castro. Plays for the Cup side, San Jose. Branam will clear. That time she was pressured. Kept alive, near sideline, then given away. Up the wing. USA using that speed. Shannon MacMillan outside. Staying with her was Contreras. Well, stumbled, got back up, no foul call. They went with the advantage call. Welsh pushes back. Here it comes, but it's high and wide of Ella. Foudy missing that one. She thought it was deflected, was it? Apparently not.
Well, Christy Welsh could get taken down here, but in great USA American female fashion, she fights to stay up in the penalty area. And Julie Foudy ends up hitting one over the goal.
78th minute, USA leading 6-0 over Costa Rica.
Of course, I'm being facetious there. If she learns how to fall in the penalty area in a play like that, it's probably a penalty kick, but that will come in time. She's onside.
On the run. You've got Bush with Welsh making a run as well. Susan Bush inside, outside, left-footed shot was blocked. She's making a lot of attempts today to play with the left foot.
Good for her.
Here's Slate. Cutting it back again. That's blocked. We've heard about her great services in terms of the crosses, but today she's made a great effort in terms of balls cut back several times.
Well, she's got excellent speed. She's comfortable getting forward. I really think that she was looking for somebody to pass it to, and nobody appeared in the seam, and that's why it got intercepted.
All the way back, Jen Branham looks and clears. Gave it away, though. Well, she's back anyway. And that shot went wide. Aguilar looking for the opportunity, knew that Branham was away from goal. Branham's given up 3 goals this year in 3 games played, looking for her first international shutout. She's 3-0-0 this year.
She'll just continue to get better with experience. I always felt there was 2 things I look for international level goalkeepers. The first thing is exceptional athleticism, and for sure Brianna Scurry epitomizes that. The second thing is mental skills, and that comes with experience.
You think you were harder on the goalkeepers?
Hard on them?
Harder, no, harder because that was your position?
Well, I just understood it.
USA looking for another chance, and was it out or was it not out? A lot of confusion. It was apparently out. I'm sorry, you can finish.
I just understood the position, and I really think the key at the highest elite levels is the mental skills and goalkeeping. But you got to have that athletic package to start with. We can teach them techniques and tactics.
Costa Rica in the 80th minute. They've only had a couple of shots, actually 3 shots today now, and no shots on goal. Join us every Monday for ESPN's new show regarding Major League Soccer. It's called Extra Time, co-hosted by Rob Stone and Roy Wegerle. Highlights, features, you name it. Major League Soccer finally has its own show each and every Monday late nights. Coming back, MacMillan. Right side, Whalen.
inside the box. There's the feed. Take down there. And Arrow will pick it up. Push one down. And now it's clear.
If we get a replay on this, JP, we'll see if it's it's a penalty kick. Well, it's hard to see from our angle. Didn't look like there was a lot of contact. Whatever contact there was from behind. I didn't see the penalty kick.
USA looking for it. This portion of the match being brought to you by Bud Light. Fawcett is back there. Touched over to MacMillan. MacMillan has one of the team's goals today. Serlenga with three of them. Welsh and Bush, the other goal scorers. Played across by Bush. Welsh with another finish. She has two.
Well, Julie Foudy plays Susan Bush in, and Susan is a take-on artist. Little wall pass, and here she is. She finds Welsh at the top of the six. Christy doesn't hit it just the way she wanted to, but I'll tell you what, look at her set up her defender in there. So she's shoulders are square when she strikes it, and it's in the right position, even if it isn't hit with all the power she wanted to hit in the right place, it's in the back of the net.
27 goals for her last year at Penn State. Again, let's keep in mind, only 19 years of age.
This Susan Bush has it after a great little build-up with a 1-2, and Christy Pearce finds the back of the net.
In fact, two 19-year-olds combining on that one. Bush to Welsh. Youth being served today in Louisville for the U.S. national team. They've got a 7-0 lead over Costa Rica. MacMillan breaks this up. Mellon stays with it.
Yes, that was Christy Welsh with the goal, not Christy Pearce. I'm sure Christy would have liked one, but from the defensive position, that's not as easy to do.
Pearce will play it up. MacMillan. On the turn, Whalen fires a shot! Sara Whalen! What a turn.
Well, Sara Whalen saying, you know, assists are fun, but I'd rather bend one in left-footed over the keeper into the upper 90 of the goal, and so she does. This is a great little goal. Again, Julie Foudy has a foot into this final play. Sara avoids the tackle, bends it away, and then just buries it left-footed. Look at this bent into the upper corner of the goal. That's just an awesome goal.
Well, we keep showing you Foudy because she's made the difference. But Sara Whalen gets credit for the goal. Tony, Whalen doesn't score a lot of goals. She scored six, but I can't remember one that she has scored from that far out. Taken that way, left-footed, back to goal, all of it.
Right, that's not normally the way she scores. She just kind of outruns the entire opposition and then, you know, beats the goalkeeper to the ball and sticks it in.
Foudy played it across. Just missed time, it seemed, by Welsh, who may have had some help there. The 84th minute.
Foudy again, I'll tell you, Julie's had a big piece of the second half.
She's made the difference. Slayton, great job to keep it in, apparently. Thought it had gone out. Cleared away. The USA really picked it up. They made a couple of changes at halftime, and Foudy's clearly been the difference. She set up most of these goals. May not have been the last pass. It could have been a couple of passes before it, but pretty much all of these she's been involved in.
Yeah, it's just sometimes it's the second or third pass removed that really sets the attack into play.
This is deflected, and it could have been the ninth goal. Now it's a shooting gallery.
It is, but the USA needs to get one more. I think that's what they've been after right from the opening kickoff to get nine. They knew they had the advantage because Brazil played before them. So let's see if they can get it done.
Shannon MacMillan will take the corner, 85th minute. Driven across. And that one goes out. Costa Rica's ball.
You don't often see Shannon MacMillan miss a corner kick like that. Hitting it behind the goal. Usually she's driving them in at laser speed where somebody can just redirect it with a foot or a head.
Push back, Contreras lost it. The recovery was made, or was it?
Good defense there.
Foudy came in, now it's cleared. Pushed all the way back to Branam, 86th minute. Pearce, up the wing, right side, Sara Whalen. Puts on the brakes before the end line. Plays it back. MacMillan. Shannon MacMillan bends it, but it goes wide. 86th minute. USA up 8-0 over Costa Rica. We played Brazil on Tuesday. We mentioned tiebreakers before. First tiebreaker head-to-head, which would be even if they tied on Tuesday. Goal differential next, which would be even if the score were like this. Goals scored. You know what the last one is, don't you? The last?
Yeah, it's flip of a coin, so we want to avoid that. It's an embarrassment for FIFA, I think.
We've seen that in a lot of rules, but I've never seen it ruled, have you?
Well, I think what they need to do is, instead of going to flip of a coin, and if it ends up a tie, you do go to penalty kicks. Yeah. Anything. Penalty kicks are awful, but anything is better than the flip of a coin.
Have you ever seen a coin flip done?
I haven't, but I'm sure it's happened.
But I've never seen it either. 87th minute. USA up 8-0. Of course, you can forget about tiebreakers if one of those two teams wins the game outright on Tuesday. Contreras. Here's Slayton coming back. And that one's cleared away. And no foul called on either player. Welsh picks it up. 88th minute. Slayton.
Around again.
Cuts it back again. There's a player open inside. Settled. Look at Foudy. Just so calm, pulling it back. Right side. Pearce. Bush. Give and go. And Bush may be tiring out a little bit.
Well, the pass was just overhit a bit. It's good they were looking for that combination at the top of the area.
When the USA takes on Brazil on Tuesday from Foxborough, it'll be, or should be, the most competitive match, certainly, so far anyway. It will be in Group A. Two teams that, well, the gap is getting a little bit closer now. Brazil is, I think, the most improved team since the mid-90s.
Well, they're certainly the most improved team in the 90s, and there's a lot of pride for both these countries in soccer, and that's going to be a very entertaining game.
Pearce, right side, 89th minute. That's tackled out. Throw in for the United States. Christie Pearce is ready. Another one of those versatile players, can play a number of positions. Back to Foudy. Miller. Slate has Chastain with her, instead finds Serlenga. Nikki with three goals today. MacMillan may have a go. She gets in. Off air and then off the post. There was your tiebreaker right there.
MacMillan hits a dipping shot. She gets this off, kind of dips under the keeper, and just the upright saves it. I'd like to see another U.S. player crashing in to put away that rebound.
Chastain from Foudy. Pushed across, Danielle Slayton. Big strides from Welsh, and the ball is knocked out by Christy Welsh, who has a couple of goals today. Coming off the bench.
Give it up wide!
The cheerleaders today, Christine Lilly, Mia Hamm, of course, hadn't played either, Tiffany Milbert.
But it looks like they're warming up on the sideline, JP. You know what that means? It means there might be some fitness after the game, which is, you know, Christine Lilly is probably excited about that, because sitting for this whole game is probably, she needs to run.
This one goes out of play as well. We're in the 90th minute. See how much stoppage time is put on before this one comes to a close. On a hot day in Louisville, Kentucky,
Watching Gold Cup 2000 on ESPN2. Foul called on the U.S. They're only going to put a minute on of stoppage time, and we're into that minute now. Contreras sends it long, turned away by Chastain. Out of the back, MacMillan from Pearce. Foudy, half a minute gone in stoppage time. Cleared up. That one's blocked.
They had a good buildup going there. Serlenga just didn't hit it the way she wanted to.
Branam backing up, clearing it. Brought down by Madriz. Should be just seconds left in this one. Referee has glanced at the watch. Foudy from Whalen. Outside Slayton. Over a minute gone now in stoppage time. Foudy played it up. Serlenga the turn. Keeps going. Lays it off. This one goes wide of Ella in goal. USA secure in their first two games, not giving up a goal and really hardly giving up a shot on goal. Against two of the weaker teams in the group, they'll get their first test against Brazil on Tuesday. Here's a long one coming back. Gotta stop that. So much for a minute of stoppage. We're headed for two. This one's blocked out. A throw-in coming up for Costa Rica. And it'll be from the near side. U.S. getting it back. That'll do it. Well, we almost went to 2 minutes of stoppage time. April Heinrichs has to be happy with this effort today. The two teams now, USA and Brazil, are in a dead heat, but you did so well for this team today.
That's right. You want to give the you want to give your young players a responsibility to do something important, and they did it, winning 8-0.
Giving you a complete view of the world and Austin 24 hours a day. The news and information you need is on Time Warner Cable. Beyond the headlines, first on the scene, delivering the coverage you can only get from cable. In-depth coverage from the experts, inside business, sports, local weather, politics, and entertainment. Worldwide in Central Texas, 24 hours a day. It's value you can see.
There ain't any other way to put it.
Only on Time Warner Cable.
Faster than a speeding bullet, more powerful than a locomotive, able to leap tall buildings in a single bound. Superman, Krypton Coaster, soar to heroic heights, feel the rush, the power, and ride the wind. The only flawless coaster in Southwest. Now at Six Flags Fiesta Texas.
Save $12 at Six Flags Fiesta Texas when you bring in any Coke can product.
Soccer fans, get ready for great MLS action. When you order MLS ESPN Shootout, you'll get up to 100 matches you can't see anywhere else. So bring the action home. Order now. Call your cable company, DirecTV, or Dish Network.
Soccer's where I met Tracy.
I met Felix.
We all play together.
We have fun together.
He's the coolest.
My nickname is Bigfoot.
Goalie Queen.
They call me Bulldog because I'm really aggressive.
Soccer makes me feel pumped up.
It gets you stronger.
It makes me feel great.
Soccer's when I run faster than anyone.
I could play forever.
Bud Light, proud sponsor of the U.S. women's soccer team and the 2000 Olympic Games.
Hey, Brandi, watermelons are on sale.
Wait up, in Frodo's.
8 countries, 160 women going toe-to-toe to be the first Gold Cup winner. So much for world peace.
Come
see the action of the first ever Women's Gold Cup soccer tournament. For tickets, call 877-407-TICKS or visit womensgoldcup.com.
Well, the other night we had the Cindy Parlow show, but today, Tony, it was time for Nikki Serlenga to shine. That's one of her three goals scored of the day.
Here's another one, JP. Little touch off by Susan Bush, and again, Serlenga finds the corner. And then her last one, she's laid off. She beats the player to her right, but drives it back to her left, and another corner for Serlenga. Hat trick.
Serlenga with three goals today. Five now for her international total. And we'll have another one coming up for you Tuesday. This one should be a heck of a lot closer. A great rivalry has developed between the United States and Brazil. It continues on Tuesday from Foxborough Stadium. We'll have full coverage here on ESPN 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific. And the winner of that game, assuming that there is one, wins Group A. USA and Brazil, Tony and I will have the full call of that one. Well, the USA's offense was in full gear today, much like it was the other night. Even with the six changes they made in the lineup, U.S. beats Costa Rica. Final score is 8-0. Stay tuned. Coming up next, the incredible dog challenge presented by Purina. For Tony DiCicco, I'm John Paul Della Camera. Thanks for watching. Today's game has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. For more, log on to ESPN.com, a part of the GO Network. GO.com. See you Tuesday.
Got my shades for the California sun. Got my guys together.
Come on, take me out of the crowd. Hey, good.